It's been a while since we've been in the studio with our cameras. I've been in the studio, we just haven't brought the cameras in. So I'll give you a quick little synopsis of what's been happening since way back in March when we made our last video. April and May were potting months. I only have three customers, but they're three good customers and they will buy as many pots as I want to make and keep me as busy as I want to be. And sometimes they'll buy more pots than I want to make. So April and May was getting clients ready and stocked for the summer season. June was our trade show. Every June we have our Coots Days here. And last June, whenever that was, we had our second annual Coots Days Art, Craft and Trade Fair. And it went really well, but that putting on all of that takes a lot of organizational skills, which for me is a bit of a test. Jim was busy in June with a seniors conference, and we also busy with Coots Days doing other things, getting the parade organized. But the trade fair went really well. We had some outdoor vendors, and we had more vendors than we had the year before, bigger and better. We had people staying in the school, and we were offering showers to people, and getting all of this together happening and coming across as making it look like we knew what we're doing is a bit of a test. But it went well, and we're looking forward to doing it again next year. I have to admit, though, we were busy up to the end of the trade fair. We did take a week off in June there and do nothing and take the whole week to finish. And then July came, and July was what I call company month. And it's great to see the family. The first week of July, my brother-in-law, Jim's brother, Dwight, and Laurel came. They're a lovely couple from Vancouver. No, they moved to Kelowna. And they came anyway, and we thought, wouldn't it be fun? We're going to put on a pulled pork, and we're going to go hiking and riding on stone. Now, riding on stone is a park about, oh, half an hour from here. It's beautiful, the hoodoos, and there's a nice long hike through the valley, and check it out. It's a great park. So I put on pulled pork for supper. We went for a hike in riding on stone, and we took a long way home around Melk River and stopped at Riverside Market, and they have a lovely little ice cream stand. We had ice cream cones and went home. And it was a great visit. So the next week after that, our son from Virginia comes, and he brings a lovely little grandson, Oliver, and our daughter, his sister, came from Edson, and I thought, well, that worked really well, so let's put on a pulled pork, we'll go to Riding on Stone, we'll walk through the hoodoos, and we'll stop at Riverside Market and have ice cream. So the week after that, my sister comes to visit, and this is working, so yeah, we did the pulled pork, and we did Riding on Stone, and we stopped for ice cream. And then the week after that, our son from Edmonton came, and I had enough pulled pork riding on stone, and I was sick of ice cream. We ate and drank stuff. It just didn't include ice cream or pulled pork. I haven't had pulled pork since. Anyway, so that was July. August, I do have a part-time job at the post office, and the postmaster was gone, so I worked 2 weeks in August at the post office. And it didn't burn down or anything. And so that was taken up. And then one of the outlet we have in Waterton, I thought was supplied for the summer, but the product was doing really well and she was out of pot. So I spent the last bit of August getting her supplied to finish her off for the September-October end of her season. And September rolled around and we wanted to put in a back door. Now we live in a mobile or a trailer or a modular, what do you want to call it, a long narrow house with two doors in the front. But we park in the back, so we want to put a back door in. So there was a funny little awkward cupboard. So we spent the first few weeks of September, we ripped out this awkward cupboard and took down some walls and then cut a big hole in our house and put in a door, built some steps, and now we have a back door. And I've mentioned reciprocating saws before. They're very exciting because they can just go through anything. And it's kind of exciting, scary, to take a reciprocating saw and cut a great big hole in your house. But nothing fell down and the door opens and closes, so we must have done okay. So that brings us up to today. And I have to start getting ready for the Christmas market. I came in here a couple of days ago when I threw these bowls and I worked on these slabs. Now these bowls are kind of interesting. One of these bowls, I'm not sure which one, will go to Ottawa. There's a fellow who 10 years ago bought a bowl, and he has made bread in his bowl every day, but he lived in Iqaluit. We shipped it up way up north to Iqaluit, but his work has taken him now to Ottawa, and he still has his bowl in his kitchen in Iqaluit, easy for me to say, but he's living and working in Ottawa, and he needs his daily bread. We all need our daily bread. So he wants a second bowl for a second kitchen in Ottawa, so that's going to go to Ottawa. These three planters are going to Georgia, and if you're watching this blog, Jeremy, yes, they're yours, and they're not quite ready to go, but as you can see, they're in the process, and they'll be trimmed today. The slabs, I was playing a little bit with thickening up the edges. Sometimes you just cut them off, even with their sponge, they look kind of not as tidy. The first one I did, I touched the heck out of it, and it's just mummed and touched and messy. I don't like it at all. But the second one, when I put on the turkey platter, just makes it look nicer, thicker, and more finished. I'm going to do that to that turkey platter today. These other ones I'm going to leave just plain because they don't charge very much money, and they take a long time to put the coil around to tidy the edges. So that's this table. That table over there, I came in yesterday to trim these bowls. They were too soft yesterday, so I threw those bowls. Today I'll trim them. They just look like worn little bowls. Some will be yarn bowls, some will be pedestal bowls. As I mentioned, I'm getting ready for the Christmas market. It's nice to have a little candy dish on a pedestal. This big plop on my table is reclaim. You can't see, and you'll never will see, I've got a big plop on that side of the studio, about 6 months of reclaim. I don't throw it out. I'm thrifty, as my grandmother would say. It's expensive clay. I have to drive 3 hours to go get it, 3 hours to come home, and I just keep it all in the bucket and I splot it out and wedge it up, and it goes back into production. So the time I get that trimmed, that wedged, these trimmed, and the edges tidy, it'll be a day.